Yankee.
I'm not a Yankee. Go.
Bravo, bravo, bravo.
Merci beaucoup, messieurs.
Attention!
He's alive. Thank God. Move slowly.
He's a goddamn Yankee.
Cain, the war is over. Give me the water.
Could be one of Benedict's men, you know.
He's a human being. He deserves our help. Okay.
Okay. Enchanté de vous connaître, mademoiselle.
What'd he call you?
I don't know. It sounds foreign.
It's probably one of them bandits that crossed over the border.
No, I think it's French.
French? French, Mexican, it's all the same to me.
Are you gonna help me or not?
When I get back, I think it'd be best if he was gone.
Thank you, ma'am.
In case you get hungry. It's all right. Excuse me. You must have dropped that.
Désolé.
Now, I won't take no for an answer, Miss.
Please, stop.
Leave her alone, Mitchum.
Oh, I'm just trying to help.
I said leave her alone. Get away from my wagon.
How do you suppose you're going to make me do that, rebel trash?
Thank you. Miss Mary?
Cain. I hope you two came into town to accept my offer.
We're not selling.
Everything's for sale.
Forget it, Benedict. The answer's no.
Why don't you have a talk with her, Cain? And you? I've never seen you before. What's your name?
Charlegrand, monsieur. Joseph Charlegrand.
Charlegrand. Frenchman, huh? And what are you doing in my town?
Maybe you're here for my tournament.
Just passing through, sir.
Yeah, and we'll see to it that that's all you do.
Thank you, Mr. Charlegrand.
Well, what are you two standing around about?
I seen this kick fighting before, Mr. Benedict. Last month, another foreigner, a blonde fella, killed three people in a card game in Carson. Two with his feet.
Is that a fact? Sounds like we got a major invasion on our hands. Why don't you do something constructive? Find something to do, you two.
Mr. Charlegrand, I wanted to thank you. It's good that you stopped me. Otherwise, I would have killed them.
Yes, obviously, yeah.
Mr. Charlegrand, are you hungry? Mary's a great cook.
Hey, what kind of fancy fighting was that?
Savate.
What?
Savate.
Savate.
Yeah, it's French boxing.
They sure got a fancy way of doing things in France.
Well, it's still fighting. There's nothing fancy about fighting.
Women, they just don't understand.
Thank you, dear Lord, for the food we are about to receive. Help us on our daily quest as we try to do your bidding, to stay on the path of righteousness. Help us resist temptation and evil, and to humbly serve your good name. Bless our new friend who helped deliver us from adversity. May we all live in peace.
Amen.
Amen.
Mary, the man who marries you is going to be one lucky man. Now, I know it ain't none of my business, but what were you doing in the desert so close to the Rio Grande? A lot of deserters coming over the border there.
I can assure you I'm not a deserter.
Well, yeah, but what are you doing in San Miguel? You here for the tournament?
Just passing by.
Too bad. A lot of prize money.
Hmm.
That was really an excellent dinner, Miss Mayor.
Especially the apple of the earth.
Apple of the earth?
The pomme de terre.
Potato.
Potato, well, everything we ate tonight came from this land, our farm. It ain't much, but it's home.
Where are you headed?
I'm, searching for a friend.
What makes you so sure you'll find him?
He'll be around.
He's a friend.
I hate to tell you this.
Zechariah?
Benedict bought us out.
God damn. How much did he pay you?
$100 silver.
$100? Zechariah, you sold your soul for $100?
Even if we didn't sell, I'd never be able to pay taxes on it.
It ain't even sure we got to pay. We're supposed to find out tomorrow. Couldn't you waited one more day?
Even if they accepted the appeal, who's gonna guarantee my water won't be poisoned or my livestock won't be run off? Gotta understand, I barely got a crop in this spring.
Damn, Benedict.
We can't do anything until we have proof.
Mary, don't you start that again.
Benedict or no Benedict, I'm sorry. Enough is enough. We're leaving.
Y'all just take care of yourselves, okay? God bless.
God bless you, too. Goodbye.
Yeah.
What about this tax, Cain?
The region colonel wants us homesteaders to pay $1,000 in tax, otherwise we lose our land. Looks like the Yankee army's never gonna let us be.
Cain, we made it through the war. We'll get through this, too.
Did you go to the law?
Filed for an appeal a few months ago. The colonel's supposed to be delivering an answer tomorrow. In any case, it don't matter none. We ain't giving up our land. It's Benedict!
Cain, don't you bring that shotgun out here! I will not have guns waving on my property.
I'm here to give you my final offer.
I don't need your $100.
After tomorrow, it won't be worth living.
You're so sure, huh?
Look, I can either get it from you or the state of Texas, and it really doesn't make any difference to me. I'm just trying to help you and the other squatters out.
We're homesteaders.
We don't need your help, thank you. Get off my land.
I still own this property. I want you off.
Mitchum.
Mary!
Get off my property.
Mitchum, I'm warning you! Spirit! Oh, you're mine, you! Stop it!
No!
Get her!
Oh,
Hold it. I'm a businessman, not a killer. My patience does, however, have its limitations.
These people told you, get off their land.
I'm trying to be reasonable. If there's bloodshed, it won't be my doing. Put it away, Mitchum. Get on your horses. Let's ride out of here. Now!
We gotta be tough with them.
Ouch, Mary, be careful.
People so quick to panic. Strength comes in control.
Ow!
Why does Benedict want this land so badly?
We don't know for sure. He came into town right as the war was ending. Loaded with money. He thinks he can buy everything.
Don't you have, how do you call it, sheriff?
The sheriff? The only law that rules this land is a gun.
Ah! Mary!
I'm going to sleep. I'm tired. Mary, see to it Joseph gets one of my clean shirts. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
I think this should fit. How did you get this?
Shaq bit me.
Let me wash that shirt for you.
Thank you, and good night, Miss Mary.
Why don't you put that knife away, Slim, before you cut somebody? So how much trouble do you think the Frenchman's gonna be?
I'll handle him.
Is that a fact?
Yes. He hadn't to stop me. He'd already be taken care of.
No. I want an outsider to do this. That blonde-headed fellow Slim was talking about. Get him.
Come.
Come! Come, yeah! Come!
Appeal on April 11th for an injunction against the state of Texas was heard by the federal court for the region of the Texas territories, and it was denied.
Denied! How can he deny what's right?
Quiet!
By proxy of the state of Texas, I do hereby impose the following property tax. For protection from any hostile forces, that is, Indians or otherwise, the state of Texas will levy a tax to each community of homesteaders a total of $1,000.
That's too much.
We can't pay that. Sit down!
Failure to pay the said taxes will cause a forfeiture of land to be taken over by the state of Texas and resold.
How dare you? I fought the same army as you, and now you're going to steal my land?
Yeah, right, exactly.
I tried to do everything I could, but it's orders from Washington. The tax will be paid right after the 4th of July celebration.
Well, you heard the colonel. My offer is now $50 per homestead. Well, you know where you can find me.
I'm gonna sell. At least I get something for my land. Enough to get us to California.
People, think about this. We're talking about our homes, our land, our dreams.
Cain, where are we gonna get $1,000?
Well, how much have we got?
Between all of us, maybe $200.
All right. All we need is 800 more.
Might as well be 8,000.
All we need. I suppose you got a plan to come up with the rest of the money.
Well, I know where I'm gonna get 500 of them.
Cain, you're crazy.
You can't win the tournament.
Well, yes, I can. It's just like fighting Yankees. No offense, Cody.
None taken, but according to my calculations, still $300 short.
None of you all bet on me.
Well, what if you lose? That money is all we got.
People, think about this. I'm gonna fight. You all do what you want.
All distance. From here, English boxing. Now from here, we have box française or savate.
Coup de pied bas.
Ow.
Coup de pied au flanc. And different kicks. And finally from here.
Boom. This is a rare fight.
But always with honor.
All right. Now it's your turn.
Around these
parts, I just grab you by the waist and I'm picking you up and muscle you to the ground. Cain, the men you're going to be fighting have been doing this their whole lives. You're going to get yourself hurt.
No, I ain't going to get hurt, Mary. Not with Joseph's fighting tricks, I ain't.
Cain!
Mary, at some point we have to stop running. We have a right to defend what's ours. Where's your dignity, girl? What would you do, Joseph? You'd fight, wouldn't you?
Of course he would. He's a professional soldier. Fighting is his life. You could win this tournament.
Well, this is not so simple, because...
Someone's trying to scare us off.
Someone, Mary? You know that someone is? Benedict. What are we gonna do?
We can always build another barn.
This ain't right. This ain't right. This ain't right. This ain't right. We'll be right back.
Lonesome in that cowboy.
I believe that's yours.
I believe you're making a big mistake.
Oh, I don't think so. That is yours.
What is the nature of your business, kid?
This man attacked my farm. I'm sure some of you were there also.
Well, that is a very serious accusation. I hope you're prepared to back it up.
This man attacked my farm.
It looks to me like we're just gonna have to settle this matter here and now. Way we settle things here, fair and square. That is, if you're man enough.
What's the matter? Course too tight, Dixie boy?
Put him away.
Cain, no. Don't.
I am truly sorry, Miss Mary. I tried to warn him, but, well, you know how he is. He wouldn't listen to me. You can take him and he's right on out of here and no one will follow. Now you've got my word on that. And as for you, Frenchman, I don't have a beef with you.
Good man, Mary.
Well, take care of yourself, Mary. If you decide to come to California, you know you can live with us. Ask her. I don't know what she's going to do. Maybe you ought to talk to her. You know.
Listen to me. Please.
Don't give up your land.
We just buried a man of honor today. And as a friend and officer, I would respect his honor.
I will take Ken's place and I will fight in the tournament.
Yeah, we may still have a chance.
What's going on?
Kommen Sie hier rein.
Benedict, sign me up for tomorrow.
Oh, well, well. Mr. Von Trotta, it is a pleasure.
I congratulate you, Herr Benedict. You have reunited two old friends. Mein Herr is very famous in Europe. They say he is the best.
Can you beat him?
What the hell you think you're doing, miss?
That's great. Better future in the hands of a guy that can't break a window.
Shut up, you deaf Yankee.
Damn Frenchman's good.
So was Von Trotta.
I want some insurance.
Who is this man to you?
His name is Ziegfield von Trotta. He killed civilians in Mexico.
My camarade Philippe and myself witnessed it. It was a court martial. He claimed he suffers from night blindness. He was demoted of rank. Since that day, he swore he would get back to us.
Oh.
medallion stopped the bullet. I wish it was me. Not Philip.
I can't go. I can't watch this.
We want to put
all
of it on Charlegrand.
All of it.
$197 on that Frenchman.
Come on, boys, let's speed it up. We got to get started here.
Push it up, fellas.
Step right up. This is your lucky day.
Thank you.
I'm awful sorry, Miss Mary.
Let's go!
Senor Benedict.
Don't worry, Miss Mary. I wouldn't harm one hair on that pretty little head of yours. I do, however, need this. Try to be a gentleman, Mitchum.
Yeah.
that away.
Yeah.
I've been waiting for this.
Well, now, who said chivalry was dead?
Yeah, it is a pity. You are an entertaining fighter to watch.
Sergeant Major.
My pleasure. See, I'm not a well man.
Oh, yeah? Cancel the tax.
The tax is not real.
What did you say?
The tax is fake. He needed the land. The railroad is coming.
The railroad?
The governor's gonna announce it very soon.
Very soon.
And you knew this all along? I hope that you burn in hell for what you've done.
Oh.
Your leg. You're hurt. It's over.
Not yet. Because if I don't fight, you will lose the money everyone gambled.
Folks, Mr. Charlegrand will be here.
Hope so. I told you we shouldn't put all of our money on the Frenchman.
He'll be here. You just gotta have faith in the man.
He will.
This is for Cain. This is for me.
They sure can't fight like that.
I don't see how I can.
Where's that leave us? Faith.
When Napoleon went into battle, he used to wear a red shirt. His name is Ziegfield von Trotta. He claimed he suffered from night blindness. Night blindness.
Ah! This is for you.